Try to finish everything today.
We're ready to resume, Mr. President. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, at this juncture, I move that we consider the budget of the office, the budget of the Department of Education and its attached agencies, the Office of the Secretary, Early Childhood Care and Development Council, National Book Development Board, National Council for Children's Television, National Museum of the Philippines, Philippine High School for the Arts, National Academy for sports. And we'd like to acknowledge the presence of its officials led by no less than our Vice President, the Secretary of Education, Vice President Sara Duterte. Mr. President, we now recognize the distinguished sponsor of the measure, Senator Pia Cayetano, and first to avail of the interpellations, but I was told that he would just make a statement and a manifestation of support. May we recognize the distinguished gentleman from Davao and Batangas Province, no other than Senator Christopher Bongo.
So before we recognize them, we'd just like to once again welcome back Vice President Sara Duterte, and of course the DepEd family. I made a mistake earlier when they came. I said the DepEd family, it was the OVP family pala. So now I'd like to welcome as well the hardworking men and women of the DepEd with us, together with its attached agencies. So we'd like to recognize the distinguished sponsors, Senator Pia Cayetano, and to make a manifestation, our distinguished colleague, Senator Christopher Lawrence Bongo. Please proceed.
Mr. President, my honorable colleagues, and of course the Department of Education officials led by Vice President Sara Duterte, magandang araw po sa inyo lahat. First, I want to express my support for the budget of the Department of Education, and I would also like to congratulate the Vice President and the DepEd for launching the Matatag Curriculum Bansang Makabata Batang Makabansa Agenda. This program definitely marks a crucial moment in our nation's educational landscape, and I believe it will play a crucial role in addressing the challenges that we face in our education system. The Matatag program is truly a testament to the visionary leadership of the Vice President and the Secretary of the Department of Education. With this, Mr. President, I would also like to express my support for the increase in the budget of basic education facilities, which was allotted with an additional of 10 billion or a 44% increase from this year's allocation. Importante po ito para matugunan ang kakulangan sa mga classroom, lalo na ngayong balik na tayo sa face-to-face na po ang mga estudyante at mga guro. Marapat lamang po na mabigyan ng pansin at solusyon ang mga problema ang kinakaharap ng ating mga estudyante dahil sa kanila nakasalalay ang kinabukasan po ng ating bansa. As discussed in the committee hearings, there is a total of 159,000 classrooms that must be constructed all over the country to bridge the classroom gap. In fact, sa pag-iikot ko po sa buong bansa, halos inilalapit po sa atin ng mga teachers, kulang ang kanilang mga classrooms, lalong-lalo na po sa mga liblib na komunidad, kulang talaga yung mga classrooms. Marami po ang nagpapatulong sa atin at nilalapit naman natin ito sa departamento, yung mga kakulangan po sa classrooms. Napansin ko rin po na may mga eskwelahan pa rin na hindi maganda ang kondisyon, sira-sira ang bubong o yero pa rin ang bubong, hindi maayos ang silid-aralan, maruruming palikuran, kahoy na pundasyon at marami pang iba. Pati po, yun po ang hinaing ng mga teachers natin. In fact, nung bumoto po ako nung last barangay election, mismo po dun sa sudad kung saan po ang ating Vice President sa Davao City, marami po mga sementado na ng mga classrooms, pero marami pang naiwan ng mga classrooms na kahoy po yung bubong, sira-sira yung yero. So talagang kahit sa mismo sa Davao City, kulang pa ang ating mga classrooms. Hinaing po yan ng ating mga teachers. Inilapit po sa atin. I just want to share that when I voted recently po yan, last October 20, kailan yun? October 30. I witnessed firsthand the sorry state of the facilities in Buhangin Central Elementary School. May sementado, may kahoy po. Paano po makapag-aral na maayos sa mga bata kung yero po ang kanilang bubong, napakainit niyan, kung kapag tanghali at hindi rin makatulong kapag umuulan. That is why I am with the Vice President and the DepEd in their efforts to improve basic education facilities. And I support, Mr. President, increases in the budget for this program. Second, Mr. President, as DBM Secretary Pangandaman mentioned during the DBCC committee hearing and during plenary interpellations, there is around 17 billion already earmarked for salary standardization 6 in the proposed 2024 budget. With this, government workers may expect increases in salary next year. Sana po ay matuloy ito at isa po tayo sa magsusulong nito at kasama po dito ang ating mga teachers. Nevertheless, I just want to take this opportunity to urge the DepEd to push for the needed increase in salaries and allowances of teachers. Pag-aralan po natin kung anong benepisyo po ang dapat ibigay sa ating mga guro bukod po sa kanilang sweldo. Despite the pressing challenges in public education during the pandemic, teachers were able to adapt and respond to the challenging work situations. They went above and beyond to ensure the delivery of education for their learners. It is therefore just incumbent upon us to recognize their devotion and invaluable contribution to the formation of our youth and society. Additionally, Mr. President, I would like to mention for the record the reduction in the proposed budget of the National Academy of Sports. As one of the authors of this law, along with the sponsor, Senator Pia Cayetano, Senator Sunny Angara, and Senator Win Gatchalian, during the 18th Congress, we want to highlight the importance of NAS in developing the athletic skills and talents of the students in world-class sports facilities while also focusing on their secondary education. Dito po sa NAS, pwede silang mag-aral yung mga atleta at the same time mag-training. Pwede po silang mag-training at the same time mag-aral. Wala pong masasakripisyong oras. Despite the additional budget for capital outlay and personal services in the committee report, hope we could find ways to further support the provision of scholarships of National Academy of Sports. Lastly, Mr. President, I laud the Senate for adding 3 billion in the budget of the Department of Education. At sisingit ko na lang po, hinahangaan ko po si Vice President Sara Duterte for no longer pursuing the request for confidential funds so that we could already settle this divisive issue. Nananatili po ang aking tiwala sa ating Vice Presidente at sa ating Secretary po ng DepEd. Isang boto lang po ako dito sa Senado, pero bilang kasapi po ng Senate Committee on Basic Education at Vice Chair po ng Committee on Finance, ang position ko, kung ano man po ang tinanggal na budget sa DepEd, dapat itong ibalik sa pamamagitan ng mga programa na makakabenepisyo sa mga kababayan natin, lalong-lalo na po sa mga classrooms na backlog natin. At ang makikinabang po dito dapat, yung mga kababayan nating mahirap. Hinggil naman po sa OVP, sana po mailaan natin ang mga programang makakatulong, lalong-lalo na po sa mga mahirap, katulad po ng medical, burial, and other assistance po na alam naman natin na nakakatulong po sa mga kababayan nating mahirap. Ngayon na isinasaayos na natin ang budget para sa susunod na taon, unahin na po natin sana ang trabaho, unahin natin ang pagserbisyo at tulong po sa mga mahirap nating kababayan. That is all, Mr. President. I have no doubt that with the leadership of Vice President Sara Duterte and the continued support of all stakeholders, the Department of Education will achieve even greater milestones for our students and the education sector as a whole. Maraming salamat po, Mr. President.
Thank you very much, Senator Bongo. Majority Floor Leader.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, next to ask questions, Mr. President, is the distinguished gentleman.
Yeah. Actually, may opening statement pa po.
Yes, Mr. President. Mr. President, may
you recognize
may I just
sponsor, yes.
Move that we recognize the sponsor of the measure, the Senior Vice Chairperson of the Senate Committee on Finance, Senator Pia Cayetano.
So Senator Cayetano is recognized.
Thank you. Just to put on record, Mr. President, the budget. I'm ready to sponsor the budget of the Department of Education, the Office of the Secretary, with a total new appropriations of 715,839,092,000 pesos. Also, the Early Childhood Care and Development Council with a total new appropriations of 290,166,000 pesos. The National Academy of Sports with a total new appropriation of 230,587,000 pesos. The National Book Development Board, with a total new appropriation of 178,471,000 pesos. The National Council for Children's Television, with a total new appropriation of 82,080,000 pesos. The National Museum of the Philippines, with a total new appropriation of 1,364,202,000 pesos. And the Philippine High School for the Arts, with a total new appropriation of 98,241,000 pesos. With this, Your Honor, I'm ready to accept questions from my colleagues.
Thank you very much, our dear sponsor, Majority Floor Leader, who are next in line to propound some questions. Majority Leader.
Mr. President, first to ask questions on the budget of the Department of Education is no less than the distinguished gentleman from the great province of Isabela and the Davao region, no other than Senator Rafi Tulfo. I move that he be recognized.
Our distinguished colleague from Isabela and Davao, no other than Senator Rafi Tulfo, is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Senator Pia Cayetano. Mr. President, I would like to put it on record that I fully support the 715 billion pesos or more, the budget of DepEd for 2024. I don't have any problem with that whatsoever. However, just like before during the committee hearing, I just had some few concerns, and those concerns weren't really answered because for the lack of time, and I was informed that I need to produce certain documents to justify some things that I did mention during that particular hearing. Ang concern ko lang po talaga, for the longest time...
May I just, before the gentleman proceeds, the Senate version is now 718.08.
Okay, 718. Pesos. Let's make it 719.
No, we have to be accurate, Your Honor.
Okay, 718.08 billion. Like I said, I don't have any problem whatsoever pagdating po sa budget ngayon for 2024 para
Thank
sa DepEd.
You.
Wala po tayong question dyan. Regardless, kahit na po medyo kumulang, wala pa rin po akong problema.
Thank you.
Para maging klaro po tayo. Ang problema ko, ang issue ko lang po kasi, for so many years po, sa programa ko sa Wanted sa Radyo, palagi po ako nakakatanggap ng reklamo mula sa mga magulang ng mga estudyante sa elementary at high school na karamihan sa kanila ay mga mag-aaral, mga magulang mag-aaral ng mga security guard, kasambahay, factory worker, na sila po ay naobliga mag-contribute na required ng eskwelahan through PTA para sa iba't ibang mga pangangailangan tulad ng electric fan, tulad ng jobos, tulad ng bond paper, tulad ng pambayad para sa sweldo ng security guard, sweldo ng janitor, para sa utility bills, etc., etc., etc. Na hindi po dapat dahil meron man po talaga budget ang DepEd dyan through the MOOE. Now, paano po nakukolekta itong perang ito para magkaroon po tayo ng idea lahat? Ang nangyari po ay dinadaan sa PTA, Parents Teachers Association. Now, pag-start po ng school year, nagpapatawag po ang PTA ng General Assembly. At pagdating po dun sa General Assembly, magbobotohan sila muna ng mga officers. Right after na maboto po yung officers, ang next agenda agad ay maghanap sila ng proyekto. Kailangan nila mag-identify ng proyekto para sa eskwelahan. At ano po yung mga proyektong yon? Yun po yung mga gastusin na akin pong binanggit. Okay. Now, I want to put a stop to it. I really do. As much as possible during my watch as a senator of the Republic. Pero napagsabihan po ako noon na kung gusto ko pong baguhin yung pulisiya ng pangongolekta to PTA, gumawa rin po ako ng batas. Now, I don't have to. Dahil nakita ko na po, very clear na sa akin, na meron naman pala talagang batas. Kaya lang, yung batas na yun ay hindi na-implement. Republic Act 4206, noong 1965, na-enact yan, which prohibits collection and even voluntary or otherwise, from elementary schools sa public schools, except for Red Cross, except for in fact, the only ones that was mentioned was Red Cross. Now, noong 1969, RA 5546 was enacted para ma-amend yung 4206. Dito po sa 5546, mas lalo naging malawak po yung prohibition sa collection. Maybe the good sponsor might want to react doon po sa dalawang batas na akin pong nabanggit.
Thank you. Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, the concern of the gentleman was raised during the hearing. And the Vice President Secretary of DepEd responded by mentioning Department Order Number 49 Series of 2022, which is a no fee, no collection policy. Tama ba yan? No fee, no collection policy, which they are strictly implementing. And it was further discussed during that hearing that there is the PTA in almost every school that does their own fundraising efforts. And it being a parent-initiated organization, they are allowed to do that. So we, in connection with the law that His Honor pointed out, that is exactly consistent with the department order of the department.
But the department order cannot supersede.
If I may just continue, Your Honor.
Okay.
So the department order has the very same policy. No fee, no collection. The department and all their subordinates, meaning the teachers, are not allowed to initiate or to tolerate these collection efforts. But this does not prevent the parents from having their own fundraising. This system has been practiced for decades. Ayan, finally lumakas. The system has been practiced for decades, and it has been a private initiative of the parents that has allowed many projects to see the light. No, anything from gate, fencing, gardening, events. It's a PTA initiative, and I think that's why it was mentioned that if there is a desire to change that policy, there must be a law, because currently the DepEd order is consistent with the existing law mentioned by His Honor.
Okay, Mr. President, may I ask the good sponsor kung sabihin niya sa akin yung bang department order na yon at saan po doon sa dalawang batas na binanggit ko, RA 4206 and RA 5546, alin doon na nagsasabing pinapayagan na mangolekta ang mga eskwelahan o mga magulang para sa kontribusyon sa eskwelahan. Can you please show it to me? Maybe I can help the good sponsor para mas mapabilis tayo rito, if she will allow me to.
Your Honor, if His Honor can, Mr. President, if His Honor can give me a minute to just review, and then I will be happy to yield the floor, of course, anytime.
Yes, sure, session suspended for me.
Thank you.
Saan ba yung ano, kinukot ko sa po?
Ready to resume.
Session resumed.
Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you for the patience of the sponsor. As His Honor had pointed out, it's a 1965 and 1969. No, the first one was 65 yata and 69 law. So this representation had to refresh herself on those laws, Your Honor. Hindi pa ho ako pinapanganak noong 1965. Nung inamen, pinanganak na ako, pero hindi ko pa to nabasa, inaamin ko naman po. Anyway, if we may go to the very important point of the gentleman, no? First of all, let's put on record that we respect His Honor's concern for the parents, no, who have expressed their problems, no, who have reached out to share their problems. No, we respect that, Your Honor, and we totally respect and appreciate His Honor's persistence in bringing this to the attention of DepEd so that if there are solutions that can be made, they can be made. With that in mind, Your Honor, the question of His Honor, if I may paraphrase it to be sure that I respond accurately, is meron namang batas na nagbabawal na magkolekta ang PTA. Tama ho ba ang intindi ko sa tanong? Is that a correct understanding?
RA 5546, bawal po talaga ang contribution collection sa mga estudyante whatsoever, whether yan ay voluntary other or otherwise, except for Red Cross, Girl Scout, Boy Scout, and Barrio High School. Yun lang po talaga minention sa 5546. Wala nang iba pa. Kaya kung meron pong ginagawang collection other than those mentions, then that is against the law, against 5546, which is happening right now in so many public elementary high school. And marami pong lumabas na mga department order, and I can mention a few of them, na they're trying to circumvent the law para lamang matuloy yung gusto nila mangyari ng eskwelahan na kumolekta. Ang point ko lamang po dito, Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam, mag-implement na tayo ng policy. Meron tayong law, then dapat it's up to the executive para ma-implement itong law. Because the last time I was informed na gumawa ako ng batas para ma-implement na raw, mag-implement ng batas. Nagagawin ko, I don't have to because meron na palang dalawang batas, Your Honor.
Yes. Your Honor, Mr. President, His Honor is correct in his paraphrasing or delivering the provisions of RA 5546 kung saan ho, and I will just read it, no, para clear, yes, ang maintindihan din ng mga kasamahan natin yung issue po na malapit po sa puso ng ating kasamahan. The section 1 of RA 5546 states, the sale of tickets and or the collection of contributions in any form whatsoever by any person for any project or purpose, whether voluntary or otherwise, from school children, students and teachers of public and private schools, colleges and universities is hereby prohibited. Tama po, sir, no? Yan, Mr. President, yan po ang tinutukoy ng ating kasamahan. Tama po. Tama ho ba?
I agree.
Yes, okay. So, nung ako ho ay nakikipag-diskusyon sa DepEd, aware po sila dito na bawal talaga ang collections of contributions in any form from school children, students, and teachers. And that is why in their Department Order Number 49 Series of 2022, known as the Promotion of Professionalism in the Implementation and Delivery of Basic Education Programs and Services, prohibits DepEd officials and employees from seeking contribution, support, solicitation of any kind or any kind of intervention from non-DepEd entities. It goes on to say, likewise, the department implements a no-fee collection policy wherein no fees shall be collected from learners in kindergarten up to grade 4, while fees on certain memberships may be collected from learners in grade 5 and above, strictly on a voluntary basis, i.e. Boys and Girl Scouts, Philippine National Red Cross, Parent Teachers Associations. So ito po yata, sir, ang implementing order na hinahanap nyo, Mr. President. Do I respond to His Honor's question by pointing out this DepEd Order Number 49?
Thank you, Mr. President, Your Honor. Pero can a department order supersede a Republic Act?
Mr. President, in my humble legal opinion, this department order is consistent with the law. But I am very open to hear His Honor's concerns kung meron dito sa department order na inconsistent, kasi isa po ako sa naniniwala na hindi talaga dapat nagsusupersede ang isang department order. We are one with that.
Thank
and
you.
I let the record show that the minority floor leader is nodding his head, because for more than a decade, magkakasama kami always reviewing this department orders. Hindi ho tayo nagtotolerate na nag-exceed.
Exactly.
So, nagkakaisa po tayo dyan, Mr. President.
Pero dito po sa RA 5546, Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam, totally pinagbabawal ang any form of collections, voluntary or otherwise, except Red Cross, Girl Scout, Boy Scout, and then donors for the support of Barrio High School. And I have a definition of Barrio High School with me. Never did this RA mention about PTA.
Yes, Your Honor. We noted that the mention of PTA is now in that department order. Upon further review and discussion with the DepEd, we are now looking at the entirety of RA 5546, wherein it states, thank you. Mr. President, when we look at RA 5546, Section 1, and I will read it again, the sale of tickets and or the collection of contributions in any form whatsoever by any person for any project or purpose, whether voluntary or otherwise, from 1, school children, 2, students, and 3, teachers, are hereby prohibited. So in the case of the PTA, Your Honor, what has been the policy of DepEd since 1969, just to be clear, it is not the policy of this administration alone, but since 1969, nila ang policy, is that there is a total ban on collection from the children, the school children, the students, and other teachers. But they recognize PTA as a separate entity that on their own have their own rules and guidelines, and may on their own come up with fundraisings that are voluntary in nature.
Fundraisings, okay.
Well, just to be clear, Your Honor, okay. That is my own choice of words.
That's
Mr. President, yung fundraising. No?
Okay.
I use it generically po,
Madam,
Mr. President.
Meron ba diyang batas na kung saan, batas tayo, dinidefine ang meaning and function ng PTA? Alam niyo po ba yun?
Dito sa RA 5546, wala hong banggit ng PTA.
Tama.
Pero I will ask DepEd if there are
don't ask DepEd. Ako
I don't need to know. Okay.
Ako nang bahala.
Yes, Mr. President.
PD 603, December 10, 1974, dinefine ang meaning ng PTA. At nowhere here na nagsasabi ang PTA pwedeng mangolekta Ang sinasabi rito, ang PTA ay isang programa samahan na para tulungan ng mga estudyante sa kanilang academic performance. Kung ano mga problema ng estudyante, anong problema ng mga magulang at teachers tungkol sa estudyante to enhance their participation sa eskwelahan, yun po yung purpose. Look at PD 603, ma'am. I'll give you a minute. PD 603, December 10, 1974. It is a forum being provided by the law para yung mga magulang at ng mga estudyante at guro ay magkaroon ng pagkakataon mapag-usapan yung welfare ng mga estudyante. Yun pong pinakabuod. Never doon sa PD na yan did mention na pwedeng mangulekta ang PTA ng contribution o collection para sa mga proyekto ng anumang mga proyekto sa isang eskwelahan.
Mr. President, I will respond to His Honor's observation on the definition of PTA. Umpisahan ko po kung ano tong PD 603, no? This is the Child and Welfare Code. Familiar po tayo dyan. It's basically a law that governs, is meant to protect children. And Section 70, ano yun? 77. Section 77, just to be clear, malawak ko itong batas na ito kasi ito din ho ang naging foundation ng Foster Care Act na naging basis ng mga amendments natin on foster care law. So it's a very general law, quite detailed, no, in various ways of protecting children. So there is a section on home and school, chapter 2 po ito. And Article 77, as his honor correctly points out, mentions parent-teachers association. It states, every elementary and secondary school shall organize a parent-teacher association for the purpose of providing a forum for the discussion of problems and their solutions relating to the total school program and for ensuring the full cooperation of parents in the efficient implementation of such programs. All parents who have children enrolled in a school are encouraged to be active members of its PTA and to comply with whatever obligation and responsibility such membership entails. Parent-teacher associations all over the country shall aid the municipal and the local authorities and school officials in the enforcement of juvenile delinquent control measures and in the implementation of programs and activities to promote child welfare. Mr. President, in response to His Honor's concern or conclusion that the Parent Teachers Association do not have the authority to collect. Tama ho, no, sir, Mr. President? That is the question, no? That the Parent Teacher Association, by definition here in PD 603, do not have the authority to collect. That is the question,
let
correct?
Me rephrase what I said. Mr. President, Your Honor, I want a clear definition in our law that states that the PTA is allowed to collect contributions voluntary or otherwise. Saan po sa ating konstitusyon? Saan po sa ating batas? Yun po gusto ko para maging malinaw po sa ating lahat.
Yes,
dapat
understood.
Po nandito, meron po ba? In fact, ang nakita ko lamang pong definition ng PTA, which is sabi mo very vague, general, is PD 603, pinakamalapit. However, dito sa PD 603, hindi po sinasabi na ang PTA ay binuo para mangolekta sa mga estudyante ang mga eskwelahan. Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam.
President, I just needed to confer with DepEd if tama po ang intindi ko. So in Article 7 in Article 77 of PD 603, which I had just read into the record, as I said, it states there that that every elementary school shall organize ito nga hong PTA relating to the total school program to ensure full cooperation of parents in the efficient implementation of such programs to address. They are meant to create a forum to address the problems and the solutions. So the practice of DepEd has been to support the to allow the PTA to follow the mandate of Article 77, and if they need to raise funds to be able to address these problems and solutions, including the implementation of the programs, then they are governed by their own guidelines in implementing those programs,
sorry,
including
President.
Yung at tapusin ko lang po,
sige po,
including yung fundraising. Yan po ang naging practice ng DepEd since 1969 po.
Practice is different from what the law says. There, yes, there, you can practice anything you want. Pwede mag-practice ang DepEd. Lahat ng klaseng practice na gusto nila. Pero dapat nandoon sa batas. Pero kung wala sa batas yan, then yung practice na yon ay labag sa batas.
There
again,
is actually, Mr. President, no prohibition.
Sinabi mo kasi, Madam, fundraising. So pwede mag-fundraising ang DepEd. It's been a practice to the DepEd, magkakaroon silang fundraising under PD 603. Pero, Mr. President, Your Honor, sa PD 603, wala talaga ako makita rito, kahit na letter by letter, tinitingnan ko, wala talaga nagsabi rito na pwede mag-fundraising, na pwedeng humingi ng contribution, humingi ng tinatawag na voluntary contribution. Wala talaga. So it seems to me na yung DepEd ay gumagawa-gawa ng sarili nila ng guidelines sa isang batas. Gumagawa sila ng sarili nilang IRR.
Mr. President, I'll go back to what the Republic Act states. It prevents, it prohibits collection and contribution from students. And so the policy of DepEd has been to allow the PTAs to follow their own guidelines wherein contributions among the parents are allowed. So okay. To be clear, just to be clear, Mr. President, importante po na maliwanag yung pagsagot ko sa napakamahalagang tanong ng ating kasamahan. Bawal talaga ang pagkolekta sa estudyante, and that is being honored by DepEd. In other words, hindi pwedeng maglabas ang DepEd, ang principal, ang teacher ng request or request for contribution na ibinibigay sa estudyante. Bawal po talaga 'yon.
Bawal. But, so kung bawal po, bakit correct. Po nangongolekta pa rin sila sa mga estudyante, especially po
Mr.
sa mga hirap?
Mr. President, I would like to clarify, never po sila nangongolekta sa estudyante. Wala okay. po silang collection sa estudyante. Ang meron, so
I'm
that,
sorry,
we, are,
sorry,
so
I,
that
I,
we can
I
identify the issue.
I beg to disagree, ma'am. Ito po, lahat na mga nagsumbong sa akin.
These
are the list of parents na nagsumbong sa akin, iba't ibang eskwelahan sa buong Pilipinas, na kung saan sila po ay sapilitang kinukolektahan ng mga electric fan at kung ano pang mga gamit sa eskwelahan, na meron man pong budget sa MOE, ang DepEd, for those things.
Yes. Mr. President, first of all, may I request that list is submitted
so that we can give
it to DepEd, kasi I believe they have committed in the hearing pa lang na any violation po, iimbestigahan naman po nila. They made that commitment po. The only item left for the discussion on the floor right now is yung authority mismo ng PTA. So any direct contribution o collection sa estudyante, talaga hong iimbestigahan nila. So tama, ang pagkaintindi ko, Mr. President, sa issue is, so si PTA ba pwedeng mangolekta? And ang sinasabi po sa atin ng DepEd, the policy since 1969 has been to recognize the PTA's authority to decide among themselves. They have their own rules, they have their own guidelines to do their fundraising, that is a generic term that I'm using, among the parents. Hindi to sa bata, hindi apektado yung pagpasok ng bata, hindi apektado ang grade ng bata. Bakit ginagawa ng parents yun? Kasi kulang ang pondo. Yung sinabi ng ating kasamahan na nasa MOOE yan, meron yan pambili ng electric fan, idagdag ko na rin doon, ano yung mga kakulangan, di ba? Yung pagpaganda ng garden, driveway, entrance, kung ano paman. Lahat naman po yan nilalagyan ng MOOE. Pero if I may call the attention of our chairman, talaga naman hong wala na ho tayo, nagbibigay ho tayo ng maraming pondo, but hindi ho talaga nakukumpleto, no? In fact, ako na magsasabi, because baka may magtanong, yung mga repairs, no? Pagpalagay mo ng may electric fan dun sa loob ng classroom, o di kaya yung picture na pinakita ni Senator Bongo, medyo bumagsak yung kisame, lahat po yon falls under repairs of basic facilities. Pero natanggalan po yan ng pondo, na ilipat po sa ibang pondo yan, hindi ho ng Senado. So may mga issue pong ganyan. I want to assure our colleague that hanggat makakaya, sinusuportahan ng ating chairman yung ating recommendation to increase the MOOE. So that basic principle, I think everyone in the Senate supports his honor na mapondohan sana ng lahat na yan. So, remaining na lang po yan kung ano ho, hanggang saan ang kakayahan ng PTA to among themselves decide to fundraise parent to parent. I cannot add to my answer kasi yan po ang policy. Hindi ko naman ho kayo bobolahin, Mr. President, na iba yung policy. Yan po ang policy na ginagamit po nila. So kung may recommendations, suggestions ang ating kasamahan, this representation is happy to relay at nandito naman ang DepEd para pakinggan ang mga suggestion ng ating kasamahan.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, the good sponsor, Honorable Congresswoman Pia Cayetano. Senator Pia Cayetano, sorry. Thank you. Pero gusto ko lang pong balikan, Mr. President, Your Honor, yung sinabi mo, it's been a long time practice. Tama?
Policy po.
Policy, okay, sige. I stand corrected. It's been a long time policy na pinapractice sa DepEd for so many years. Na hindi ka, ilan sa atin hindi pa niya pinapanganak dito. Of course, ako pinanganak na ako dyan. Pero dapat a policy should be dictated by the law. So is there a law na kung saan sinasang-ayunan ng policy na sinasabi nyo matagal ng pinapractice ng mga taga-DepEd? Dapat lahat ng mga bagay na ginagawa sa ating mga eskwelahan, lalo sa DepEd, na who's receiving a lot, lots and lots of budget by the billions, dapat nandoon nakasaad sa batas. Hindi yes. Pwede po silang gagawa-gawa ng sarili ng policy na wala po sa batas. Dapat lahat po ng pulisiya nandoon po.
Mr. President, may I respond to that statement? Mr. President, as I said, no, kaya ho ako nag-abalang ipaliwanag na ang PD 603 is a very broad law intended to protect the rights of children. Kaya nga po, Child and Youth Welfare Code ang pangalan nito. And there is just one chapter on home and school, which is only two articles. So, dito po sa articles na to, at binasa ko naman on record, yung pag-create ho ng PTA, wala na hong detalye yon. The fact, Mr. President, that there is no prohibition, that there is no provision that specifically or expressly prohibits the PTA from engaging in certain acts to pursue their mandate.
Yes, in, there is.
In Mr. President, if I may just continue. My statement is, the fact that there is no provision that expressly prohibits the PTA from pursuing their mandate is in itself unaccepted principle that there is no violation. It is a rule of statutory construction that what is not expressly or impliedly prohibited by law may be done. So yan ho ang ating statutory constructions when it comes to prohibited acts. So pag sinabi po natin bawal ito, then we need to produce that law that prohibits it. And so we do have yung dalawang RA na binanggit naman ng ating kasamahan. Meron nga hong RA na nagbabawal.
Yes.
But that is why I have been repeatedly explaining that since 1969, ang implementation ng ating DepEd dito, they believe that they have been implementing this in the true spirit of the law na nagsasabing bawal mangolekta sa bata. They cannot collect contributions from school children, students, and teachers. Yun ho ang specific wording of the law.
Exactly. Ah, sige. Pagbigyan ko po, I yield my floor to
Mr. President.
Majority,
yes, minority floor leader.
Thank you. With the permission of my colleagues, the good sponsor mentioned statutory construction, which I used to teach in law school. We have to harmonize, and I'm thankful for the discussion. At least we brought out the RA 5546. And then Article 77 of the Child and Youth Welfare Code. Kung makikita po natin, yung RA, bawal mangolekta sa bata. Okay. Actually, sino kinokolektahan mo kung nangongolekta ka sa bata of elementary school age? Hindi ba magulang din? So if you look at the spirit of the law, bawal mangolekta sa bata at sa kanyang magulang. Ang proviso sa dulo, kung out of the goodness of the heart of the parent, willingly, without any prompting or solicitation, magdo-donate siya sa school, hindi bawal yun. Okay. And then, if you look at Article 77, shall organize the PTA, in-enumerate ngayon yung purpose ng PTA. Wala po dun because it should solicit funds to financially help the school. Wala rin po dun sa Article 77 yun. So if we harmonize the two provisions, not only looking at the letter, but also looking at the spirit, I would tend to agree with the point of our interpellator, Senator Tulfo, na bawal. And if there is a department order na may interpret na pwede for the PTA to prompt or solicit or to ask contributions from the parents, let's review this department order because in my humble opinion, it violates the law, Mr. President. So thank you for the time, sir.
Thank you, Minority Leader.
With the indulgence of our colleagues, may we recognize Mr. President, our Senate President Pro Temp, for her interjection?
Yes, sir. Distinguished Senate President Pro Tempore, Senator Lauren Legarde is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President. May I humbly suggest that since the GAA is the most important piece of legislation, it may be applicable only for the next 12 months, however, but you can keep on making it a special or a general provision. If it is the advocacy of the good gentleman, the interpellator, and if the vice chair and the chair would agree, then perhaps a draft of a special provision to reiterate an old law or a policy that may be general but may apply to that may be reiterated in a special provision for the DepEd budget to, use a better word, prohibit, not encourage, no forced contribution when applicable, when reasonable. I leave it to you how to draft it. If, based on the conversations, discussions I've been hearing, while it is a very important thing and there are many other issues in the education sector, perhaps the way forward for the solution would be a special provision. If the chair and the vice chair would agree, that would refer to policies, department orders, and the old law from the 1970s, which I heard. So that's my humble suggestion, Mr. President. How that provision will sound, will be drafted, I leave it to the body. But it may prohibit or not, at least not encourage, the contribution, especially from the poor families. Libre na nga ang matrikula, pero kung yung hinihingi ng contribution ay higit pa sa libreng matrikula, kawawa rin naman. So pwede natin gawin parte yan ng ating batas na ginagawa. Thank you, Mr. President.
Yeah, thank you, Senator Loren Legarda. In fact, if I may quote Yusek Poa, sabi niya nung last hearing, doon naman po sa overall efforts, as you know, school-based feeding program is actually one of the ways na hindi napapansin, pero ito po yung ways to prevent yung ating mga dropouts, unquote. And I agree. And that's very commending. Pero it defeats the purpose na para hindi po magkaroon ng dropout, para may entice yung mga magulang na mga mahirap na mga estudyante, mga mahirap na magulang na may mga estudyante, na papasukin sa eskwelahan ng kanila mga estudyante dahil wala nang mga kain sa bahay. Di ba? Para naman mabusog pagdating sa eskwelahan. Pero pagdating naman sa eskwelahan, kokolektahan mo ng kung ano-ano. Then, yung iba pa nga sa kanila, yung mga sumbong sa akin, sir, naglalakad na lang alam po ako, 2 kilometro, kasama pong aking tito, wala po akong pampamasahe, pudpud na nga po yung aking tsinela, sapatos. Pagdating doon sa school, ine-expect kami po ay magbigay ng para sa electric fan. Ito pa po, para sa kalaman ng marami. Kuminsan, pinapahiya pa po yung mga estudyante. Nagkakaroon po ng group chat. Nakalista doon sa group chat, sino-sino yung mga nagbigay at sino-sino pa hindi nakapagbigay. So yung mga hindi nakapagbigay, peer pressure, it's either gagawa ng remedyo para makapagbigay, masama sa listahan, matanggap ng grupo, or hindi na lang papasok kasi napapahiya sila. Magda-drop out na lang. Sayang yung feeding program. So, what I'm trying to say here, Mr. President, napakasimple nang naman eh. Okay lang may PTA. In fact, wala akong ano dyan, wala akong against it sa PTA. Use it properly. Dapat yan, eh, talagang nababantayan ng DepEd. Dapat yung PTA, gamitin lamang yan para pag-usapan po yung pong mga problema ng mga estudyante at mga guro para tingnan at i-monitor yung mga activities ng mga estudyante, yung kanilang academic performance. And this is the truth. Your Honors, siguro meron kang estudyante sa public school. May anak ka ba? Maybe wala. Or maybe may staff ka na nag-aaral sa public school, because marami akong staff na nag-aaral sa public school here in the Senate, saka sa RTIA. At lahat sila nagsasabi na talagang pinipilit yung kanilang mga estudyante magbigay sa contribution. Pag hindi ka nag-contribute, anong consequence? Ah, hindi ka na maging paborito ng teacher. Ikaw ay pwedeng maiwan, ikaw ay mag-scrub ng sahig. Ikaw ang mag-erase ng mga nakasulat sa blackboard. Marami pa paggawa sa iyo. Pero kung ikaw ay nag-contribute, go home ka na, maganda pa ang grades mo. Yan po ang madalas na mangyari sa iba't ibang mga eskwelahan. At yan po'y documented. At yan po'y in-interview ko po lahat ng mga staff ko na may mga estudyante sa public school na nire-require po talaga sa PTA pa lamang, binoboto na agad kung ano yung mga pwedeng ma-contribute, ano pwedeng may ayos sa eskwelahan. Just imagine, Mr. President, Your Honor, every single year, kailangan mag-contribute ang mga estudyante para sa electric fund. E kung ipunipunin natin yung contribution sa electric fund every year, eh siguro baka marami ng warehouse ng electric fund dyan sa DepEd, kung saan magdinadala yung electric fund. My question also, Mr. President, Your Honor, di ba meron pong MOOE para dyan sa electric fund na yan? Ba't kinakailangan papagbayarin yung mga estudyante sa electric fund sa jobos, sa pintura, sa bond paper, maging sa, eto pa po, sweldo sa security guard, sweldo sa janitor, pati ba naman sa kuryente. And I understand, Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam, meron po tinatawag na Special Educational Fund, ang LGU. In fact, ang LGU nagbibigay din ng pera sa DepEd, Mr. President. Sana pupunta yung SEF. Now, my question is, maaari siguro ang problema hindi nakakarating sa mga eskwelahan ang MOOE. Saan na pupunta yung MOOE? Kailangan siguro i-audit natin yung MOOE. Yan po ba ay nakakarating ng tama, o baka naman nakakarating sa mga eskwelahan pero hanggang sa principal lang? Kaya may mga balita, si principal, magaganda ang mga bahay, magaganda mga sasakyan, pero sila teacher, kawawa. So si teacher gagawa ng remedyo at yun na nga, maningil sa mga estudyante.
Kaya nga po nagsabi pa nga ng mga nakakausap ko po doon sa mga listahan, I think we interviewed more than 100. Sabi, kaya nga po kami pumunta sa public school dahil wala po kaming pambayad sa private school. Sila po ay mga tricycle driver, pedicab driver, labandera, kasambahay, factory worker, na mga underpaid, na maliliit namang sweldo. Salamat nga sinabi ni Secretary Yusek Poa, and I commend you for saying that, yung programa niyo yan na merong feeding program para hindi na po tumaas pa yung cases ng dropout para ma-entice yung mga magulang na papuntahin sa eskwela ng kanilang estudyante dahil meron ng pagkain. Gutom kasi sila, kaya hindi sila pumapasok, pero kung bigyan mo ng pagkain, papasok na sila. However, pagdating naman sa school, yung libreng pagkain, parang siningil mo lang dahil pagbabayari mo para sa kung ano ng contribution.
Sir, ano po yung tanong nyo?
I'm just making a statement, Mr. President, Your Honor, kung ano po yung sentimiento ng mga pumunta sa akin, mga magulang, libo na po sinasabi po sa akin. So what I'm saying is, we have to stop this wrong policy na kung saan nagbabiolate ng law ang kung ano-ano pong department order na ipinapalabas po ng DepEd para lamang pipilitin na makakolekta sa mga estudyante. Sabi pa nga ni Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, pag kinolekta mo estudyante, wala naman pera yung mga estudyante, parang sino kinokolektahan mo talaga? In essence, yung mga magulang. So, for me, change that policy, wag na tayo mangkolekta, zero collection na talaga, voluntary or otherwise, tulad ng nakalagay sa batas. Okay, except for Red Cross, Girl Scout, Boy Scout, and Barrio High School. Let's stick to what the law says. Stop na natin yan. Huwag na tayo magpalabas ng mga department order para we try to circumvent the law para makakolekta. Tuloy ang duda nito mga magulang, baka siguro gusto nilang magpalabas ng kung ano-ano mga department order para makakolekta sapagkat gusto nilang yung MOE hindi na makarating sa mga eskwelahan. Now, may I add, Mr. President, Your Honor, kung sasabihin nyo lang sa akin ngayon na kayo po ay mag-i-issue ng department order telling all schools under DepEd, let's stick to 5546, period, and I will sit down. Otherwise, kapag hindi, magpipilit kayo, abutin tayo dito hanggang madaling araw. And I will not stop because I know I'm right.
Mr. President, just a short response. The policy of DepEd is very clear. They have a no toleration policy on the collection from students. So, itong huling mga nabanggit ni ng ating kasamahan na yung mga estudyante nagko-collect, paulit-ulit din na sinasabi sa akin ni Vice President DepEd Secretary na no, they will not tolerate that and they commit to investigate that.
Thank you.
So clear po tayo diyan. On that note, may I ask for a minute suspension, Mr. President?
Thank you.
Session suspended for 1 minute.
Mr. President, we're ready to resume.
Session resume.
May we acknowledge, Mr. President, move to recognize the sponsor of the measure, Senator Pia Cayetano. So move.
Yes, please proceed.
Thank you. First of all, Mr. President, I'd like to thank our colleagues. No, I asked for a minute suspension to also gather the wisdom of the Senate. No, and I'd like to commend our colleague Senator Tulfo for raising this very important issue. We also took the opportunity to ask DepEd what actions, if any, have they taken upon receipt of similar complaints, and they confirmed that upon receipt of similar complaints, they have received similar complaints, and they have actually suspended airing PTAs. So on that note, Your Honor, they are prepared to issue a department order strengthening the law.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That's all, Mr. President, Your Honor. Thank you. On behalf of the thousands and thousands and thousands of parents who have students in public elementary school, would like to thank DepEd and the sponsor na magpapalabas na po kayong department order para to strengthen the law. At pag nagkaroon ng violation, magkakaroon po silang sanction. Yun lang po talaga ang gusto ko mangyari para matuwa na po yung maraming mga magulang. Thank you very much, Mr.
Maraming
President.
Maraming salamat. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Senator Tulfo, Majority Leader.
Yes, Mr. President, we thank the gentleman from Isabela and Davao for raising that very important issue, Mr. President, and we also thank our sponsor for giving us a bird's eye view of what will happen in the coming months, Mr. President. Mr. President, next to interpellate, for his short interpellation, may I move that we recognize our Deputy Majority Leader, Senator J.B. Ejercito. So move, Mr. President.
Senator, Deputy Majority Leader is recognized.
Yes, these are valid points for DepEd, Mr. President. Mr. President, Your Honor, Madam Chair, for the record, how many really is the public school classroom shortages in the country? Do you have an information?
Yes, Your Honor, we have that number. So, Mr. President, to be clear, Mr. President, we have different categories, ano, yung new classroom, repair of classroom. So I'll just respond to the new classroom. No, I would assume that's the most commonly thought of when we think of a classroom shortage. So for the new classrooms, the actual gap is 158,779 classrooms.
So for the record, that's 158,000 classrooms.
Almost
159,000. And likewise, is it true, Madam Chair, that of that number, a total of about 440 classrooms were destroyed in storms or other disasters?
That seems to be accurate, Your Honor.
I'm just worried, Ms. Madam Chair, Mr. President, because under fiscal year 2024, DepEd has an allocation of 19.6 billion for the construction of new school buildings. Is this accurate, Madam Chair? Is this in the National Expenditures Program?
Yes, Your Honor.
How much is the allocation for repairs?
6.5 billion, Your Honor.
Yes, my concern, Madam Chair, Mr. President, under the gap, I observed that there was an increase in the budget for the construction of new classrooms from 19.6 billion to 24.6 billion. However, this is my concern, which you mentioned earlier, that the repairs and rehabilitation of classrooms was decreased from 6.5 billion to 1.5 billion. Madam Chair, I'm worried because, as you know, we are in the Pacific Ring of Fire, always visited by about 20 typhoons, prone to calamities. And this is a low-hanging fruit, Madam Chair, because I was also a chief executive. I was a mayor once in my lifetime. And I know for a fact that it is much easier, faster, to rehabilitate and repair classrooms that can be used right away than to construct new classrooms. Kaya po na nag-aalala po ako, what is the reason for the increase in the budget of construction of new classrooms and the decrease in the budget of repairs and rehabilitation? Because this is a new low-hanging fruit, Madam Chair.
Yes. Mr. President, to be clear, so for the understanding of our other colleagues and yung mga nanonood nga po sa atin, tama po yung observation ni Senator J.V. Ejercito na ang ating ang nasa NEP, no, ito po yung lumabas sa DBM na budget ng repairs of classrooms is nasa 6.5. Tapos po nung dumating sa atin ang GAB, ito po yung version ng House of Representatives, lumiit po ang repairs of classroom from 6.5 to 1.5. So factual po 'yan, bumabaho ng 5 billion. So nung hinahanap po natin kung saan napunta, eh mukha hong napunta ito dito sa construction of new classrooms. Kasi under the NEP, yung galing nga po sa DBM, it's 19.5. And then ngayon, under the GAB, coming from the House, it's now 24.6.
So there's an increase, Madam Chair, of 5 billion
for 5 billion. That's why ang conclusion natin is nilipat po iyon doon. Siyempre po, tayo naman, lahat naman tayo dito, happy naman tayo, of course, for the construction of new classrooms.
Of course.
But we always study saan nanggaling yung pondo because we have limited funds. So kung yan ho ay nanggaling nga dito sa pang-repair, as His Honor pointed out, Mr. President, nakakahinayang naman kasi maraming repair na kumbaga sa less, it makes sense naman po, di ba? Imbis na magpatayo ka ng four walls
and
another bathroom, yes. Madali naman po magpaayos, di ba? Hindi naman po yung napaka-komplikado naman po ng architecture nito, di ba? Baka ho may problema lang sa bubong, baka ho yung banyo. So, mas marami ang marerepair kaysa sa matatayo sigurong bago. So nag-aalala din po tayo dyan, and I thank His Honor for bringing that up because lagi ho tayo naghahanap ng mabilis pero maaasahang solusyon. So mabilis sana ho yung pag-repair.
And likewise, so, yung classroom shortage that you mentioned, about 109...
Yes, yung binanggit natin...
59,000. I think it will be faster for us to be able to utilize classrooms that can be repaired,
yes,
or rehabilitated than to construct new ones.
Yes, and we had the opportunity to discuss this issue with the secretary and kinonfirm po niya na kailangan din nila yung pondong yan para po sa repairs.
Anyway, I also have information, Madam Chair, Mr. President, that 24.6 billion allocated under the GAB, but only 9.8 billion from the allocation is left to the discretion of DepEd. Is this accurate, ma'am? Because if this is so, from what I know, if it's DepEd, this will be needs, based on needs, Your Honor.
Yeah. So again, I'll repeat the numbers. No, nasa 24 billion ang budget ng DepEd for the new construction. Pero nung dumating ho sa atin ang galing sa House, na-identify nila ang roughly 10 billion or 14.8 billion. Therefore, parang ang naiwan na lang na budget for DepEd to construct schools that they believe are priorities is less than 10. Less than 10 billion, is that accurate? Less than 10 billion. So, we have also discussed this with DepEd because, syempre po, Mr. President, we look to the agencies for, we look to their wisdom for the implementation of their programs. We assume that they are the institution that knows the state of education of the whole country. Kung hindi naman ho issue ang funding, syempre lahat patatayuan natin bukas na bukas, lahat. Wala naman hong issue sa kagustuhan natin na lahat ng barangay magkaroon ng sariling eskwelahan. But given the shortage, I have to assume that alam ng DepEd kung sino yung kailangan bigyan. For example, may malaking syudad na maluwag pa naman ang ibang classroom, so pwede sigurong yung isa munang syudad ang bigyan, di ba ho, Mr. President? So katulad din yun na naging mayor, I'm sure may time na mag-share muna ang barangay, di ba, ng facilities. Then later, saka sila magkakanya-kanya. So, as chairman of the budget of DepEd, I do hope that with the wisdom of the Senate, no, we can assist DepEd in having a bigger say on the distribution of those schools, because we just really want to ensure, Mr. President, na makakarating sa bawat barangay ng Pilipinas, lalo na yung mga nangangailangan talaga, ang classrooms na kailangan sa lugar nila, Mr. President.
Before I end, Madam Chair, Mr. President, if example, the 24 billion, for example, can the DepEd be able to utilize this 24 billion to be able to build new classrooms?
Mr. President, sorry. Can you please repeat?
For example, we will be able to give the DepEd the discretion to have new construction, the new school buildings or classrooms. Can they be able to utilize? Kaya po naman muna niya.
Yes, Mr. President, itong 24 billion na pinapag-usapan natin, kumbaga nasala na 'yan, kasi from the past experience of this representation, we always discuss with them to ensure na kaya nilang ma-utilize yung budget, kasi ayaw ho ng DBM na nakatenga lang po yung pondo doon. Mr. President, pwede ko lang ho bang idagdag dun sa sinabi ko, DepEd has their prioritization for new constructions. It's important that we put this on record. Galing po ito kasi meron po tayong EDCOM, kung saan we are constantly in coordination with our with DepEd and other sectors. So ito po yung prioritization ng DepEd. Schools with learners having classes in makeshift or open spaces and other alternative learning spaces. Number two, schools with remaining classroom requirement shortage. So, kumbaga may school na, dadagdagan na lang. Three, replacement of school buildings totally damaged by typhoons and other calamities structurally. Four, schools located geographically isolated, disadvantaged, and conflict areas, it's otherwise known as GIDCA, with high incident of poverty. Five, schools damaged by calamities that are not included in the QRF, the Quick Response Fund, and schools with no program construction for the past 5 years. So ito ho yung set of priorities ng DepEd, and as the sponsor of their budget, nais ko din naman po na masunod itong priorities.
Thank you, Madam Chair, Mr. President. Likewise, I would like to reiterate that we're hoping that the budget, the allocation for repairs and rehabilitation will be restored. No? Because as I mentioned, again, I'd like to reiterate, this is a low-hanging fruit that the students will be able to utilize as soon as possible. Because as I mentioned, we are being visited by a lot of calamities or even storms every year. May nakita ko mga nakatiwangwang because of lack of funding for repairs. So I'm hoping that we can restore this, Madam Chair, because I think it will be more practical and it will be it can be utilized easily by our students. That's all, Mr. President. Madam Chair, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you to our colleague.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank Mr. You. President, next to interpellate is our minority leader, but Senator Bato de la Rosa, the gentleman from Davao and Bohol, would like to make a statement, a manifestation. May I move that he be recognized, Mr. President?
Our distinguished colleague from Davao and Bohol, no other than Senator Bato de la Rosa is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President, Majority Leader. Madam Chairman, good sponsor. Good afternoon po. First, short manifestation of support, manifestation of gratitude, and manifestation of appeal. Number one, I would like to manifest my support for the approval of the budget of DepEd. And number two, ako po'y nagpapasalamat from the bottom of my heart to our DepEd Secretary for forgetting about the confidential funds, and it spared the Senate from debates regarding this issue. Maraming salamat po. At number three, I would like to appeal to DepEd na sana to remind always their teachers about the legal doctrine of locus parenti, which emphasized the legal responsibilities of the teacher who are entrusted by the parents doon sa kanila mga anak. And in line with this, remind ko rin sila, itong Article 218 of the Family Code, the schools, its administrators and teachers, or the individual entity or institution engaged in child care shall have special parental authority and responsibility over the minor child while under their supervision, instruction, or custody. Authority and responsibility shall apply to all authorized activities, whether inside or outside the premises of the school entity or institution. Kaya ko ito binanggit, Mr. President, dahil nga, sana, appeal ko sa kanila is that, Madam Sponsor, even without the confidential funds, sana siguruhin natin na wala na mga bata na ma-recruit ng CPPNPA doon sa kabundukan at makipaglaban sa ating gobyerno at mamatay. Yun lang appeal ko, Mr. President, good sponsor, dahil nga, noong 18th Congress, the last Congress, no, we were together with a good sponsor noong nagkaroon tayo ng hearing about those missing minors, lumalabas talaga sa investigation natin na ang mga bata na nawawala at napunta sa CPPNPA ay nanggagaling dyan sa senior high school, grades 11 and 12, which is under the care of DepEd. So, Mr. President, good sponsor, sana isipin palagi ng mga teachers kung bilang second parents ng ating mga anak, these children are entrusted to them. Alam natin, during the hearing, palaging ini-emphasize ng mga school authorities na we cannot do otherwise because of academic freedom. They are free to choose kung gusto nila mag-rebuild or what. But sana, very clear dito sa ating family code na dapat may responsibilidad ng mga teacher pagdating sa pag-alaga ng ating mga kabataan. Kung ang parents ay ayaw na magiging rebuilde ang kanilang mga anak, you, being the second parents, ay dapat ganun din ang paningin natin sa mga bata na dapat hindi ito ma-recruit ng CPPNP, hindi ma-radicalized, hindi ma-recruit, hindi aakyat sa bundok, mag-armas, lumaban sa ating gobyerno at mamatay na walang kasaysayan yung kanilang buhay. So yun lang po, good sponsor, ang aking apila sa ating Department of Education. Sana po nakikinig yung ating mga teachers ngayon. Sana, hindi na muli rin. Because we are on the last stretch of our campaign against this insurgency. Pero ngayon medyo nabuhayan sila. Nabuhayan yung mga komunista dahil nga parang lumalabas na talagang panalo sila. Nahinto nila yung DepEd from having their confidential funds, which supposed to be used doon sa paghinto, sa paglaganap ng recruitment doon sa mga kabataan sa senior high school. Another topic, Madam Chair, good sponsor, is about the salugpungan schools. Alam natin na itong mga salugpungan schools, they are being run by the CPP-NPA. And during the last Congress, mainit ang bakbakan dito about this. And I was assured by the then Secretary, Madam Liling Briones, Secretary Briones, na wala na daw existing na salugpungan schools ngayon sa buong Pilipinas. And I hope, kasi itong mga salugpungan schools na pinapatakbo ng CPP-NPA in DF, ay ito yung nag-sprout dahil sa kawalan ng DepEd sa kanilang area. So sana lahat ng barangays, mabigyan natin ng proper educational institution, particularly sa basic education. Dahil susulpot na naman itong mga salugpungan schools at kawawa ang ating mga bata at a very young age ay napupunta na sa armado ng CPP-NP. Kasi nga, as you record, according to DepEd, 55 Lumad schools operated by the Salugpungan Taitang Igkagunon Community Learning Center Incorporated sa 2019. I hope hindi na ito maibalik. And 12.3% of the rebels who surrendered to in 2016 to 2020 were minors aged 12 to 17 years old. Ito mga edad na ito ay obviously nasa basic education ito na edad. So I hope Madam Chair, good sponsor, through the DepEd officials, remind palagi natin yung ating mga teachers about the doctrine of locus parenti. Maraming salamat. Mr. President, Madam Chair, thank you po. Salamat.
Yes, just like to add that we support the efforts of Senator Bato and all our the government agencies to reduce the insurgency in our country. But I would like to ask Senator Bato de la Rosa, did you accept the Vice President's invitation for you to climb Mount Apo?
Well, Mr. President,
there was a challenge.
Well, Mr. President,
Mount Apo challenge.
Because of my eagerness to accept her challenge, na-overtrain ako, Mr. President. Nagkaroon ako ng injury dahil every morning nag-treadmill ako for more than 1 hour. Kaya ito ngayon, back to zero na naman ang preparation ko. But kahit na halos kalahati lang yung edad ng ating DepEd Secretary sa akin, lalabanan ko siya sa akyatan kahit saang bundok dito sa Pilipinas. Masabigyan mo lang ako ng...
Bawal helicopter, Senator Bato. Lakad talaga.
Lakad talaga ito, Mr. President. Lakad talaga.
Sige.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Bato.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, next to... make a very short manifestation is the distinguished gentleman from the province of Cavite, Senator Francis Tolentino. I move that he be recognized.
My distinguished colleague, Senator Francis Tolentino, is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President. I totally associate myself with the manifestation of our dear colleague, Senator De La Rosa, especially as to the locus parenti doctrine. And I fully know that the DepEd family is doing the best efforts to address the concerns, especially in areas far from the urban centers. And Mr. President, the good sponsor knows fully well that I'm multitasking. I'm also preparing my lesson plans for today. I have a class within 2 hours. I'm also a teacher. So again, that locus parenti doctrine do not fully explain in Dagaa or even in existing laws, aside from those mentioned by the good gentleman from Davao, is still the correct concept. The DepEd, the teachers, should be the parents of the students. Yun lang po, Mr. President, at dagang salamat.
Mr. President, thank you.
Senator Jinggoy Estrada would like to ask just one question, Mr. President. So we'll give way to his one question. I move that he be recognized, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, our distinguished colleague from San Juan. He's recognized.
If the sponsor will yield to just one question. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Your Honor. Your Honor, during the last election, the BSK, Barangay SK election, there were reports that I have received. In fact, I have a video here showing that some of the teachers in one of the cities here in Metro Manila have been accused of cheating. And I also have a picture here that a teacher read some official ballots with the stub of the upper part still attached to the official ballot. And that should have been a spoiled ballot, Mr. President. Mr. President, my question is, what are the possible sanctions that can be imposed against erring school teachers who have been caught cheating during elections? Kasi dito, sa video na ito, parang mayroong mga sinisingit na balota roon sa loob ng ballot boxes. And if this can happen to a city here in Metro Manila, it can also happen nationwide. May I know the possible sanctions, Mr. President?
Mr. President, the violation, no, of the conduct of a teacher which would amount to a violation of election laws would be under the jurisdiction of COMELEC, but DepEd can receive these complaints and forward it to
maybe
COMELEC.
I can forward the video message and the yes, pictures
of course.
Forward it.
Of course.
I will forward it
but
to
the ultimate
Department of Education.
The ultimate judge or the ones who will hear
will
this
be the
offense
COMELEC.
Would be COMELEC.
Not the DepEd.
Not the DepEd.
All right. Because this is a major concern of my part. In my part, maybe my colleagues here would also agree with me that cheating has no place during elections. That's why we have to have an orderly, peaceful, and clean and honest elections. That is why I am really very worried about the actions of some. I am not generalizing everybody, but some of our teachers who are still performing acts of cheating. And I can send this video to the Department of Education. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Jinggoy. Mr. President, last but not the least, I move that we recognize our distinguished minority leader, Senator Coco Pimentel.
So moved. Our distinguished minority floor leader, Senator Aquilino Coco Pimentel III, is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President, with the permission of our sponsor.
Of course, Mr. President.
So, we are discussing the Senate Committee on Finance, the subcommittee's report, Mr. President. Our report increases the budget of the department, of the family, by 3.499 billion. May we know, Mr. President?
3.499,
yes, with the Office of the Secretary getting a 3 billion increase under our committee report.
Yes, Mr. President.
May we find out where all of this went and why?
What is the question? Can you find out?
The distribution of the 3.499 billion increased by our committee. I think we used as the draft the House GAB, and then over and above the GAB level, we added the 3.499 billion.
So, Mr. President, the breakdown would be as follows. Support to school and learners program, that's the teaching overload pay, that's 200 million.
And this is the distribution.
And that 200 million is further distributed as follows: elementary 40 million, junior high school 60 million, senior high school 100 million. And then there is a special hardship allowance, this is 300 million. The school voucher program, 1 billion. And then the educational human resource development program, which is the training of teachers for the Matatag curriculum, that is 1.5 billion. That's for DepEd, and then there is additional 69 million for ECCD, that's the early childhood. Then there's 35.42 million for National Academy of Sports, then 25 million for NBDB, and then 20 million for NCCT, and then 350 million for NM, National Museum.
For the attached agencies. Thank you. Thank
the,
you,
the, Mr. President. The latter one were all attached agencies, Your Honor.
Thank you. So so how does this amount of our committee report, this 718 billion, compare with the NEP level for the DepEd family, Mr. President? From the NEP. Is it an increase?
Yes, Mr. President. The NEP was 714.16 billion, and our Senate report came out as 718.08 billion.
So tayo po ang nagtaas, ang Senado ang nagtaas actually. Sa House po ba ay yes?
Well, I was going to answer, but it appears the follow-up question is what did the House
sa,
do?
Sa House po ba ay binawasan nila ng 125, but 150 million?
No, Mr. President. So, ang Senate, nagtaas po tayo ng almost 4 billion.
Yes.
Ang House, nagtaas ng 395 million.
Nagdagdag pa pala.
Oo, okay. Pero pwede niyo akong tanungin kung saan napunta yun.
In spite, no, yan, tumaas pa rin sa House ang GAB in spite of their announcement that they cut the confidential fund of the DepEd in the amount of 150. In spite
yes,
of
Mr.
in
President.
Spite of eliminating that amount, the House bill still increased the budget for the DepEd family. We're talking about the family muna. The family yes. with the attached agencies.
Yes, that's accurate, Mr. Okay. President.
So meaning to say that the confidential fund of the Office of the Secretary in the amount of 150 was not taken out of the DepEd family. Nandun.
Yes, again, we are talking about the House.
Yung yes, the House. And yes, I think in the Senate also. I think we are not in the Senate. We did not restore that 150,
yes.
and yet, imbis na bumaba nga ang budget, that higher pa nga by 3.499. So, ang it's a Senate committee which augmented the budget of the entire DepEd family.
Correct.
Yes.
I hesitate to answer, Your Honor, because I don't want to violate executive session because there was some kind of decision made there, Your Honor. No, so. Can I ask for a minute suspension?
Session suspended. Alam sabi niya? Alam sabi niya? Alam?
Ready to resume, Mr. President.
Sir, sure.
So we will resume with the interpellation. Let's do this step by step, Mr. President. The House Budget Bill sent to the Senate increased the Department of Education's budget. Let's talk about Office of the Secretary lang po, Department of Education. By, let's round off the figure, 300 million? Is that an accurate statement?
395, Your Honor.
Matas mo, closer to 400 pala. 300, yes. 395 million.
Yes.
And this is despite the fact that they were supposed to have eliminated the 150 million confidential fund.
What they did, Your Honor, what the House did upon examination of the budget, the GAB that was submitted to us, is they put it under the government assistance and subsidies, educational service contracting. Ito po yung tinatawag na GASPE.
Okay. Ngayon, yung 395, so that we will understand the House bill sent to us, saan po yun na dinagdag po?
It's under the operation of schools, tama? Under operation schools specifically.
Operation of schools, ano ba yan?
No, wait. 395, what was here?
Hindi,
pero ito ba, ano? Nothing to, dito. Ito lang. So, wala to, ha? Okay, ito na lang daw.
Wag lang yung green, yung mga dagdag.
Mm. What is this? What does that stand for? General Manager. Regional Office. MOE Division Office. New construction. Ah, yung 395 lang.
Sabi?
395. Ah, kasi nag-move around kasi bali nasagot ko na yan. So, 13. Okay. Kasan yung ano? Mr. President, I apologize for the delay. I am reconciling different responses that I'm getting.
Session suspended.
Does his, ready to resume, Mr. President?
Session resumed.
Mr. President, obviously we received this over the weekend.
Yeah,
no?
Na nga.
So the our LBRMO, our in-house department assisting us, and the office of the DepEd need to reconcile. I would rather isa lang ang maibigay kong sagot kesa sa so if His Honor could move on to a different issue because I didn't know that they had different numbers, Your Honor.
Ito yung danger, Mr. President, na certified bill ang budget eh. After second reading, diretso yung third reading, hindi natin alam talaga ano yung final na forma. So, this is an example, no? Given to us over the weekend, days. Pero hindi, imposible makabisado natin and then the budget is being certified. That's why, from the very start, this representation will question a presidential certification for the regular legislative activity, Mr. President. We can even predict when it will happen, Mr. President. So, okay, so with that, Mr. President, tayo naman, and the Senate Committee naman, all we added 3 billion, as already stated by the committee sponsor,
no? Yes.
So the Office of the Secretary.
Almost 4 years.
But then our committee report also eliminated the 150 million confidential fund given in the NEP for the Office of the Secretary. That's correct. That's a statement of fact, right?
What we have, Your Honor, is upon receipt of the GAB, we retained that amount in the GASPE, as I reported earlier.
Yes. Yes, because we're talking, what is before us now is the committee report.
Yes.
Right? Our committee report.
Our committee report.
Okay, yan po pinag-usapan natin. Okay, so just like in the budget for the OVP, sabi ko nga, one of the purposes of this of hearings like this where the agencies are represented is for the agency to make a final appeal should they want some final changes to their budget, augmentation, restoration, addition, realignment, etc. So, if we can ask the agency concerned, the Department of Education, if they are making an appeal connected with the elimination. Yeah, well, that's what we did. We actually eliminated it. The elimination of the confidential fund of the Office of the Secretary to the tune of 150 million pesos.
Mr. President, the Office of DepEd, the VP Secretary, has a statement, and I'll read it. We are all parents who want to protect our children. Ang seguridad ng mga bata ay seguridad na ng kinabukasan ng ating bayan. Nonetheless, DepEd will no longer pursue confidential funds. We humbly request that the funds be realigned to the National Learning Recovery Program because we do not expect good scores for the 2022 PISA results coming out this December.
So thank you for that, Mr. President, for that manifestation. And once again, I commend our Vice President, who is the Secretary of Education, for that posture, Mr. President, for that position, Mr. President. So, May we know about the what is that program where the Vice President and the Secretary is requesting us to put the money?
Mr. President, ito yung National Learning Recovery Program. Ito po yung extra effort and initiatives to train or to provide additional training for our teachers on the most basics, yung kanilang reading, comprehension, math, which is really the foundation of learning, Your Honor, Mr. President.
Is this a tutorial, Mr. President?
Within the regular school hours. So learning time. So includes for
Anong pangalan ba? National Learning. So sa may program, may pilot program.
No. Mr. President, this is the National Learning, the National Learning Recovery Program includes, it has five sub-programs, the National Learning Camp, the National Reading Program, the National Mathematics Program, the National Science and Technology Program, and other similar programs to support learning recovery efforts.
So that program has a sub-program, but per my records, the DepEd has five regular programs. Tama po ba yan? Education Policy Development Program, Basic Education Inputs Program, Inclusive Education Program, Support to Schools and Learners Program, and Education Human Resource Development Program. So is that National Learning Recovery Program a sub-program of the five programs? Of one of the five programs?
No, Mr. President. Itong binabasa ko na National Learning Recovery Program and the sub-items there are all under the basic education curriculum.
Basic. Ano siya dito? Yes, but aren't the programs of the... Aren't the PAPs, the PAPs of the Education Department... aren't they categorized into as falling into one of the five basic programs?
Basic educational curriculum that I mentioned is under the Education Policy Development Program.
Right. So, dyan siya. Okay. So, that program has a program which has sub-programs.
Yes.
Okay. So, good luck to all of us to understand. So, ganun po yan. Okay. I mean, we also want to understand your...
Yes, of course.
Yes, your budget. Actually, maganda nga pagka-presented this, the five big programs. For example, this Basic Education Inputs Program, ito po yung may malaking capital outlays. Definitely, andito yung ating classroom building, classroom repair. Dito po siya. Tama po?
Yes, Your Honor. Hmm.
Capital outlay is 34 billion. So, can we give us the basic division of the 34 billion? New classrooms, and then ano pa yung iba?
Just
Masyado malaki yung ano na budget. Iba pa ba yung masyado malaki?
What is there? What else?
Grace, Grace.
Again, sorry, Mr. President, hindi naka, the data we have is not presented as CO eh, kasi the COs are tucked into each program.
Yes.
So, for example, basic education facilities, may CO component yon. So, I have to dissect each one to give His Honor an accurate response kung ano yung CO.
But I'm really after the, you know, I think you've mentioned it earlier also, the
basic,
what's our total budget for new classrooms?
Okay. Sige, yun, simple lang po yun, Mr. President.
But that's the charge, I guess, the 34 billion, I think. So. Ilan yun? Ilan po yun?
24.6, Mr. President.
Okay. That would be good enough for, what is our cost per classroom ngayon po ang ating ano
2.5 million, pero that includes a budget for parang support, no? Like nakakompute po yon na for how many classrooms, may bathrooms, ganun po ang computation on, Mr. President.
Kasi, Mr. President, last year,
okay.
Siyempre, paulit-ulit din naman yung mga tanong natin kasi this is a regular department naman. Ang functions din niya, predictable na. Last year, when we asked about the classroom shortage, ang sagot po last year, 167,000. This year, from the earlier interpolation, ang classroom shortage po natin ay 159,000. Is the claim that is it the claim now of the department we have built 8,000 classrooms?
Ganun ba yan? Built 8,000 or may kasama repairs?
Kakalculate tayo.
Solid 8,000 was built. Ang basta 8,000 you are made available.
Mr. President, yes, that is actually a combination of new classrooms, repairs. In other words, 8,000 plus new classrooms are made available.
Yes, okay. So yun po, to support the point of Senator JV earlier, that's why it's important that we bring back to, anong tawag mo doon? Anong condition yun? To usable condition. Those who are in disrepair. So, meron din siguro inventory naman ang department yan?
Yes, Mr. President. They actually have a request for repairs. And this is the amount that we discussed with Senator JV earlier na nabawasan po under the GAB, under the House version, yung budget nila for repairs.
Yun nga. So, in our committee report, dito lang po tayo sa ating committee, how much is the budget for repairs?
6.5 billion, Your Honor.
6.5.
Oh, so no. No, 6.5. Our committee report is 6.5.
Our committee report, the Senate committee report.
Yeah. Hindi kasi.
Yung mga higher
Mr. President, let me explain. The discussion we had with Senator JV earlier is the difference between the NEP, which is from the DBM, and the GAB. We support the NEP version because we want to have a bigger budget for repairs.
Correct.
So, but officially, what we have in the committee report is the GAB, because in terms of the time yes. constraints we had, then we just adopt the house. But that is not the personal, that is not the recommendation of the chair, and we have a lot of support from our colleagues, if I'm not mistaken, also the chairman of the Committee on Finance.
So the committee report, 1.5B?
Similar to the GAB.
Yes.
But we take
we must own up to our own committee report. That's our committee report. That's our committee report.
That is our committee report,
that's our
Your
committee
Honor.
Report. That's a Senate's committee, Senate committee's report. Ating gawa na po natin yun. Even if we borrowed it from somewhere else, gawa na natin yun. Pinirmahan, may pirma tayo rin sa committee report actually, Mr. President. So, 1.5 billion repair of classrooms. And if the House bill retained or even exceeded the level of the NEP, and yet there was a 5 billion reduction in the classroom repair level of the NEP, where did it go? Sa loob ng House bill or...
Yes, Mr. President, as pointed out in the previous interpellation of our colleague, Senator J.V. Ejercito, the House put the 5 billion into the new construction. So construction pa rin of facilities, okay. But they put it there and they have identified, as pointed out by Senator JV, they identified the schools, the areas, and that's why our colleague, Mr. President, was expressing concern that DepEd would be deprived of their ability to determine what are the priority areas. And we put on record what are the guidelines for determining the priority areas.
Correct. We should concede that DepEd has the data, the relevant data on where the classrooms are most needed. But then did our committee report retain the level of the House bill as far as new classrooms are concerned? Did our committee report retain the level of the House bill as far as new classrooms are concerned? Building of new classrooms?
Yes, because we adopted the version of the GAB, Mr. President. Yes. Pero for the record, yung sinubmit natin po is the NEP version. So I believe that there are constraints that occurred precisely because of the timing of the submission, Your Honor. To just put on record that like Senator JV, we support that the budget for the repairs would not be touched as determined as provided in the NEP, and that the construction is still there, but not at the expense of the repairs that need
we,
to be done.
Yes, the recommendation of our sponsor is, as far as construction is concerned, we retain the level of the House
NEP,
bill.
Of the NEP,
of
Your
the
Honor.
NEP. If that's the NEP, then that would be 5 billion lower than the House bill.
Yes, but level. That 5 billion yes, would to, be for yes. the repairs, which we believe is a low-hanging
yes,
fruit.
Okay.
Madali hong magpa-construct, madali hong magpa-repair.
Aba, wala pong dispute doon. I agree po ako doon. So, para po maintindihan natin, because tignan mo ako, I got the misimpression that we are 159,000 is the shortage of our classrooms. Meron na palang ibang classrooms, but in a state of disrepair. May we know, ano naman sa inventaryo po ng DepEd, how many of these usable classrooms, so supposed to be usable classrooms, so ready-to-use classrooms, which are just in a state of disrepair,
that by spending the amounts under the repair of classrooms, we can now bring them into back into circulation and use by calendar year 2024.
Mr. President, there are 202,000 classrooms in various states of disrepair.
202,000.
Yes, disrepair. Yeah.
That need to be repaired. In other words.
Yes, in effect, the statement is 202,000 existing classrooms are not being used as classrooms because they are not fit to be used as classrooms.
No, no. They are different. Yeah, some are partially used, but some would be not.
Yung totally unused is 20,750.
Out of the 202, or it's a separate number? Is that a separate number?
Yes.
Or that all is here? Okay, Mr. President, 202,000 as reported are in various states of disrepair. Of the 202,000, 20,700 cannot be used at all. So 10% more or less.
Okay.
So ito,
okay, so sana merong ka, is there a plan by the DepEd na na-compute na ba nila to bring this, sabi nyo, low-hanging fruits, we should fast-track their repair, or sige, to fast-track the repair of the 20,700 classrooms, ano po sa study ng DepEd, magkano po ito?
Mr. President, to give us an idea of the cost of, it's not a per, you know, it's an average because there are different
yes,
states.
Yes, average, yeah.
But the 6.5 billion that was in the NEP would have repaired 10,200 classrooms. So half of itong 20,700 na not usable, half of that will become usable.
If you use the entire 6.5, but the 6.5 billion is under what? The item that's for new.
No.
That's for repair.
Right now, in our committee report, ang naiwan na lang for repair is 1.5.
Yes.
So this committee will propose that the 5 billion put in the new will be returned to the repairs, the line item on repairs and rehabilitation.
So we'll repair how many, ma'am? How many, Madam Sponsor, how many? The 6.5 billion
will be able to repair 10,200 classrooms.
Okay. So if the Senate will get its way, after the bicameral maging 6.5, pwede namin masingil ang DepEd na ma-put into circulation talaga, back in circulation, 10,200
yes.
classrooms.
Yes.
Okay.
Without hesitation, the answer of DepEd is yes. Opo.
Okay. Next question. Will I just subtract that from the 159,000 shortage?
No.
Because, what that 159?
Separate kasi po yung inventory of classrooms that need to be repaired sa dun sa new construction.
Hindi po, ang sagot nyo sa akin kanina, halo na itong 159,000. Kaya nga medyo magulo.
Ah, okay.
Ayan ang sagot sa akin kanina.
So yung 159 new? Okay. Mr. President, when His Honor asked the question, ako na nagkusang nagbato na halo-halo ba yan? No? So sinagot ako ng halo-halo. So ngayon, nililiwanag nila, hindi po. Yung new repair lang talaga. Tapos new construction talaga. Yung repair lang talaga. Walang new repair.
So yung 159,000 classrooms need to be built. Okay, but that of course, because given the student population, but if we now reintroduce 10,200 existing classrooms not being used to be used now, dapat mamainusan din yung need natin for classrooms, tama?
In other words, hindi itong 202 mo, let's say lang napondohan niya. Tapos na si 159, hindi pa rin, di ba?
Hindi pa rin. So, the 180,000 needs repair, but they're still using it.
Uh-huh.
The 20,000...
So, 159 talagang kulang. Oo. Kumbaga, ma-improve lang yung status. Hindi na nagsisiksikan.
Opo.
Mr. President, hindi itong 22,000 schools identified for repair still need to be repaired kasi we're making do with those classroom. They're not in great form, pero napagtsatsagaan. Siguro nagko-combine sila ng classroom, hindi maganda yung environment doon. So, kailangan pa rin maayos to on top of the 159,000.
Kailangan ayusin naman natin yung foundation yan, built na ang walls, built na ang ceiling. Okay. Yes, I agree with the prioritization expressed by our sponsor. And according to Senator JV, low-hanging fruit itong the repair. So, you'll have our support, Madam Sponsor, if that is your proposal for the final version of the Senate budget on DepEd. Ngayon, Mr. President, yung 150 million na dadalhin natin sa National Learning Recovery Program, because I think na napag-usapan natin last year yung dismal performance po ng ating mga mag-aaral sa TIMSS, SEA-PLM, PISA surveys. What would be the expected result, Mr. President, after if we place that 150 million from confidential fund to the National Learning Recovery Program? What's now the commitment of the department that when we reassess our learners, what will happen to the test results?
Yeah. Well, actually, Mr. President, to be clear, that there are test results that are expected. Is it by December? December, no. That's a date that we do not control because these are tests happening all over the world. No, the results are released. So yung results na yan, that's not the one that we expect to see improvement because these are children who were pandemic educated. So yung 150 na pinag-uusapan natin is enhancing the curriculum basically, which we hope to see results in the years to come. Hindi naman po agad-agad, hindi naman bukas, no? So, tama ba si PISA every 4 years? So, the next testing will be 2025. Would we see results by then, 2 years? I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. Me lang, as a daughter of an educator, it takes time.
Although the program is named National Learning Recovery, it's really an investment into the curriculum committee? They will use this curriculum? Is this curriculum enhancement? Kaya tinatanong ko kanina, is this tutorial classes, remedial classes, or improving the curriculum?
Okay. Yeah. It's both for teachers and students, Your Honor, because for the outcome that we want to present itself to us, then it also starts with the teachers, diba? So may teacher training yan, and then the outcome. So all of these two components are both part of the program.
Sa budget ng DepEd, walang regular item for that? The teacher? Meron. So we're augmenting that particular item?
Yes, sir, yes. That is accurate.
So that National Learning Recovery Program already has how much in before the 150, if ever? If ever we augment it by
4 billion, Mr. President.
4 billion na po yun. Idadagdag natin.
Yes, okay, Mr. President. Po, para klaro. Mr. President, can I go back to His Honor's question, which I promised pag na-reconcile? So yung, di ba, I mentioned earlier that the gap is higher by 395 million. And His Honor asked saan nilagay. So my response to that, Your Honor, is it is placed in the general management and supervision, specifically operation of schools. 11 million is in the division of Mandaluyong, 40 million in the division of Marikina, and 300 million in Bicol region.
Is that how the department is organized? You just say Bicol region?
Well, actually, naka lump sum siya. Hindi ho siya na...
When you say division, klaro yata yun eh. Marikina division, Mandaluyong division.
Well, normally,
division,
under the division, there's PS, MOOE, and CO. May breakdown yan.
So it's a regional division?
the Bicol Region Division? Ganun po ba pag-divide natin sa ano?
Well,
sa
dito po kasi sa cities in Metro Manila nakalagay division. It's a Department of Education
yes.
You know, the way they divide the territories. Mm. Pero sa Bicol, it's Region 5 Bicol. May breakdown. So it's broken down into various regional various divisions, Division of Albay, Division of Camarines Norte,
ayun,
Division.
Okay. It's
but
there
is it's no there. Ano ba? Some have o meron na ba? PSNMOE. Hindi, pero PSMOE wala, do I say na ano? Wala. Yeah, they are placed in MOE, Your Honor, Mr. President.
Basta klaro po, klaro naman po. We just say 300 billion to Bicol, but sa schools division offices identified na.
Yes, Your Honor. Thank yes, you, Mr. President.
Huh? Now, just as we have...
Mr. President, it's 300 million.
Yes, 300
yes,
million. But what did they say? Did they say billion?
Yeah. Million.
Million. Yeah, 300 uh-oh. Million.
So accounted for so far yung 355 million.
Yes.
Hinahanap pa ng LBRMO natin yung balance of 40M.
Sige, but thank you for the effort, Madam Chair, Mr. President. So, do we also have a shortage of teachers?
Yes, Mr. Mag-ilan President. Magilan
po yun.
Our shortage, Your Honor, is 89,506.
Okay. What under what program would fall the funding for the hiring of teachers?
It falls under inputs to basic education.
And how much? Sandali, saan ba yun? Inputs to basic education inputs program. The total funding for that is 66.5 billion. And how much of that amount could be used for the hiring of teachers?
For hiring. 21.7 billion is for the hiring of teachers.
And that would be that amount would be good to hire how many teachers?
That will cover 20,000 teachers.
For the budget of 2023, how much did we appropriate under this program for the hiring of teachers for 2023?
Same.
Tapos, ang next question ko siguro is, were we able to achieve the target? To achieve the target? Or?
Last year. Pero na-fill niyo?
What, like how?
Ito PSC yung field nila ng teaching, right?
Ah, okay. Mr. President, in the 2023 GAA, the amount was 23.9 billion. And the field teaching...
What was the commitment for this year? To you asked for 23.9 billion pesos for the hiring of teachers. How many did you commit during the budget hearing last year?
To hire 9,650 teachers.
9,650
teachers.
Oh, kumusta po? Pero parang malayo pa. Bakit po? I mean, 23.9 billion for 9,650 teachers, and yet for next year, 21.7 billion to hire 20,000 teachers. Parang nagbago ba ang rate ng mga teachers?
Parang ibang na yung rate. Nakikita mo yung sinasabi mo. Last year, 23, iha-hire mo down 9. Ngayon, 21, iha-hire mo.
Tapos ito yung picture, itatanungin ko na lang yung text. Ay, ba na yun? Ay, ba na sa... Ayan, ano ko yung picture? Ano yung tatanungin natin sa office? Pag doon tayo pumatanungin sa basic, yung grace na naman yung papa, yung post. Textbook itong sakit tayo sa 12.
Ano ba yung mandala? We're checking, Your Honor.
I mean, it's suspension.
Suspension.